Bonjour et bienvenue sur ma chaîne. Hello and welcome to my channel. Actually, talking about my channel, I'm not sure whether I'm going to keep the name Learn French with Frenchizy or whether I'm going to change it to French with Cindy. Please let me know in the comments what you think. That would really help me. I hope you don't mind this more casual setting, considering today I want to teach you 5 tips to sound more like a French native. I thought that such a setting would be a bit more appropriate. So, as a little disclaimer, the tips I'm going to teach you, they're very good if you want to sound more like a native when you're in France, but please do not use them in your exams because they're not what your teacher wants from you in your exams, basically. Even though it's the way that French people talk all day, every day, in your exams, they always want you to speak like a textbook. So don't follow those tips in your exams. Only use them in France when talking to people, you know. So if you want to sound more like a native, the first thing you should do is use more contractions. So instead of saying tu as, drop the U of tu and just say ta, for example, because French people, when they say tu and the verb that follows starts with a vowel, they just drop the U and just say te, as if it was a T apostrophe. For example, t'as pris tes clés? Instead of tu as pris tes clés, did you take your keys? T'as pris instead of tu as pris. Or another example, t'es en retard. You're late instead of tu es en retard. T'es en retard. So again, we're dropping the U of tu. But this doesn't just work with the verb avoir and être. It works with any verb that starts with a vowel. So for example, say we pick the verb aimer. We would say t'aimes les frites instead of tu aimes les frites. Do you like chips? T'aimes les frites instead of tu aimes les frites. So that is a very, very common contraction and everyone uses it. Like every French person out there uses it. But this doesn't just apply to tu. When je is followed by suis, so when you are using the verb être in the first person singular, you often say suis, as if it was spelled C-H-U-I. Suis instead of je suis. And also, instead of saying il y a, which means there is or there are, we often drop il in speech and just say ya. Y a des nuages dans le ciel. Je sais pas si vous les voyez, mais il y en a plein. So tip number one, make contractions. Tip number two, when making negative sentences, drop ne. So for example, instead of saying ne fais pas ça, French people would say fais pas ça. Or instead of saying je ne vais pas à l'école aujourd'hui, they would say je vais pas à l'école aujourd'hui. Basically, when French people speak, they rarely, if ever, use ne in negative sentences. Even though for your exams, remember to use it, otherwise you will be marked down for it. So the third tip is ditch nous. Do not use nous when talking to people, just use on instead. Using nous actually sounds quite unnatural, surprisingly enough. So for example, if you want to say we're going to the beach, say on va à la plage instead of nous allons à la plage. Because nous actually sounds unnatural. So if you want to sound more like a native, you need to use on instead of nous. Tip number four, when asking yes no questions, so when asking simple questions like what's also called closed questions, instead of using est-ce que, or instead of using inversion, it would sound more casual and more natural if you simply use the statement with rising intonation. For example, instead of asking est-ce que vous allez au cinéma ce soir? Are you going to the cinema tonight? Or instead of asking allez-vous au cinéma tonight? Oh my god. Allez-vous au cinéma ce soir? You would simply say vous allez au cinéma ce soir? Vous allez au cinéma ce soir? So basically, don't use inversion, don't use est-ce que, just, Lexi, just use a statement and, right, say hello and then go, okay? just use a statement and raise your intonation as at the end. Vous allez means you're going, right? Vous allez au cinéma ce soir, you're going to the cinema tonight. But if you raise your intonation at the end, it makes it into a question. And that's usually the way that we ask questions in day-to-day life, you know. Vous allez au cinéma ce soir? Je peux venir avec vous? Right, instead of puis-je venir avec vous? Or est-ce que je peux venir avec vous? Je peux venir avec vous? Tip number 5 is use the word quoi at the end of sentences when appropriate. So, quoi translates to like something like you know or you see. It's a very common filler word basically, and it can also translate to like sometimes. You know when like it or hate it, like some people really hate when people speak that way, but a lot of people say like at the end of certain statements, and basically that's what quoi does as well. So it's a similar thing, and it makes you sound more natural, more casual, and if you need a bit of a filler, it does the job as well. So quoi at the end of a sentence can translate to either like, you know, or you see. My camera died. So let's recap. So 5 tips for you to sound like a native French speaker. Drop the ne in negative sentences. Use contractions, so drop the U of tu when the following verb starts with a vowel. Lexi, goodness, I should have put her in another room, I think. Use un instead of nous. Use statements with rising intonation when asking simple questions that can be answered by yes or no. And use quoi at the end of a sentence when in English you would use like, or you know, or you see. So, this is it for today, and now Lexi's settled. When we're done here, that's when she decides to be settled. Typical. Anyway, I hope you found this lesson useful. Let me know which of these tips, if any, you didn't already know. And I'll see you next time. Bye! Tip number 2 is use nous. No, it's the opposite.